Assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome to class 8 biology. Children, we are learning chapter number 8, cell structure and function. In our last video, we had seen about the discovery of the cell as well as we had seen the types of organisms on the basis of the number of cells present inside their body. They are unicellular organisms and multicellular organisms, right? Now, then after we had seen the shape of the cell and size of the cell, that different cells having different kind of shapes and different cells have different sizes also. Now we are moving further today with our next topic, children, that is cell structure. That what is present inside actually in a cell? What is present in one cell? Right. So the main parts of the cell are cell membrane, which is also called as plasma membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. Children, each and every cell, for example, I am drawing one of the cell over here randomly. It is not fixed that it is plant cell or animal cell, right? So this is the red colored boundary which I had drawn over here. This is the outer layer of the cell, which is outer covering of the cell, which is known as plasma membrane. Secondly, the nucleus. What is nucleus? A spherical dense body, which I am drawing over here with the pink in color. A spherical dense body present inside the cell. That is called as what, children? Nucleus. And what is cytoplasm? So, this the plasma membrane and nucleus. Plasma membrane and nucleus, iske alawa jo jelly like substance which I am drawing over here with yellow color, that is called as cytoplasm. So each and every cell, either the cell is of animal cell, plant cell, bacterial cell, each and every cell has three structures or three parts. Which are they? They are the plasma membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. Let's see in the form of image, children. So you can see in this image cytoplasm, nuclear membrane and there are three types of, as now I told you that there are three main parts. The first one is cell membrane, which is the outer covering part of the cell. Second is the nucleus, which is the dense body present inside the center of the cell. And third one is the cytoplasm, which is the jelly-like fluid in which all the different organelles are present for different chemical reactions. Okay, now let's talk about the very first part of the cell, that is cell membrane. So what is cell membrane? Cell membrane gives shape to the cell. It protects the inner parts of the cell and it is also called as selectively permeable membrane because it allows movement of materials in and out of the cell. But it does not allow all the materials to enter inside the cell and all the materials to exit outside the cell. It only allows some of the material, only selected material to enter outside the cell and exit outside the cell. That is why it is called as selectively permeable membrane. So the function of cell membrane or plasma membrane should be, we can say that it protects the cell and gives shape to the cell. Okay, now you can see in this image, children, this is the one image of the cell. In this image you can see clearly that this which I am making over here red in color, this red line, this is the plasma membrane. This is the plasma membrane, which is the outer covering part of the cell. Now next is cytoplasm. So what is cytoplasm? So as we had just discussed, that cytoplasm is a jelly-like substance between cell membrane and a nucleus. And what it contains? So it contains different cell organelles like mitochondria, Golgi bodies, ribosomes, vacuoles, etc. And so many other different chemical reactions are done here, where in the cytoplasm. The third part is nucleus. The nucleus is the spherical body and generally found in the center of the cell. Now, nucleus has three main structures. The one is nuclear membrane, second is nucleolus, and third one is chromosome that we will see in our next image. First of all, let's see the cytoplasm. So you can see clearly over here, the red color arrow shows the cytoplasm, that is the space between the nucleus and the plasma membrane. Now this is the structure of nucleus. Now inside the structure of the nucleus, very first, that is the outer covering of the nucleus, which is called as nuclear envelope, or it is also called as nuclear membrane. Now you can see, children, that nuclear membrane is not continuous. It leaves some of the spaces between them. These spaces are called as nuclear pores. Nuclear pores are the spaces from which the cytoplasm material can enter inside the nucleus, and from the nucleus the material can get outside in the cytoplasm. Now you can see the spherical dense bodies inside the nucleus, which is called as nucleolus. Nucleolus, and you can see the thread-like structures present over here inside the nucleus, which is called as chromatin. Chromatin, which forms the chromosomes having the genes, and genes having all the characters present inside them, that which inherit the transfer of inheritance from parents to offspring. So what are the functions of the nucleus, children? That first of all, nucleus controls all the metabolic activities of the cell, so it is called as control center of the cell. And secondly, it transfers the inheritance from the or hereditary identities from the parents to offspring. Now these are the structure of the plant cell and animal cell given into your textbook, children. So you can see the cell membrane, the outer covering from plant cell and animal cell, vacuoles, the large the empty spaces present inside the cell, they are called as vacuole, the nucleus, dense spherical bodies, and the cytoplasm, that is the space between the nucleus and the plasma membrane. One thing we should know, children, that in plant cell one extra layer is present outside the plasma membrane, and that is called as cell wall. But remember, cell wall is only present in plant cell. Cell wall is absent in animal cell. Now what are the differences between plant cell and animal cell? So we can say that plant cell has cell wall, whereas animal cells does not have cell wall. Plant cell has large vacuole, whereas animal cell has small or no vacuole. Chloroplast having the chlorophyll pigment due to which plant can perform the process of photosynthesis. That is why plant cell contains chloroplast, whereas animal cell does not contain chloroplast. Here we are not talking about the flagella, but as we are talking about the structure, so due to the cell wall, plant cell has definite proper shape, we can say regular shape, whereas animal cell has irregular shape. So these are the differences between plant cell and animal cell.